Hello everybody and welcome to my Dark Souls 2 Faith Build playthrough. My name is Tabriel and today we're going to continue our journey throughout Dragon Lake. In the last episode we fought our way up here to the Dragon Aerie and now we're going to finally be able to get some nice upgrade materials for my new weapon that we got in past episode. Right now we're using the Lightning Claymore, but I do want to end up using the Defender's Greatsword. However, right now, my Lightning Claymore is just that much better, so we are going to stick with that. I'm just going to rest here really quick. Okay. Now, the Dragon Aerie is a very, very good place to farm materials for the boss weapons in general, because they all drop dragon bones and stuff like that. So, am I going backwards? I think I'm going backwards, I'm sorry guys. Oh yeah, and my ring broke in the last episode as well, so I think I'm going to go ahead and pop over and get it fixed really quick. I actually totally forgot about that. Okay. It's just one of those things I didn't really think about, because it broke in the acid pit. Okay, let's go ahead and get this thing repaired. There we go.
I'll be around.
Yep, yep. Okay, now that we are here, we might as well actually level up a bit, too.
Bearer.
See, vigor, endurance. Might put my faith up a bit. Maybe my strength, I'm sure it's getting up there, but I think I might want to go into vitality and maybe a bit of endurance for now. Sorry about that, my throat is having a little bit of a problem. Okay, now let's head back. Okay. Now, there are obviously a lot of dragons in this area. Lots flying overhead, but most of them can't really hurt you. They don't do any sorts of damage unless if it's a particular event which happens later on. These guys you need to worry about a bit, but I never really had too much trouble with them. They'll fly at you, try to knock you off the bridge, basically. And if you listen closely, you can hear crystal lizards scurrying about. There are quite a lot of them in this area. I mean, a lot of crystal lizards in this area. There are an absolute butt ton. And rolling into these eggs will basically reduce the amount of time you have to walk across a bridge later on. However, we don't really need to worry about that because they'll just all come back when we hit the bonfire later anyways. So that's fine and dandy. There are a lot, as you can see, of just little areas around here that you can explore. The only way to get down there is I believe you have to drop off this little zip line area. Let's see here. Sounds like there's somebody close. Yep, it's one of those guys. Looks like you're supposed to grab this, try to grab this while he comes over and knocks you off. Okay, let's see here. Right now I'm not really going the optimal path, so to speak. I'm just kind of exploring around because there, as I said, are a lot of little areas you can go to and a lot of optional paths. Not all of them will lead to necessarily the end, but they do all lead to at least somewhere interesting that'll give you some sorts of items. Some are more advantageous than others though. Particularly when trying to combat these dragons. So, do keep a lookout. And let's see if I can take out this crystal lizard before he just... Nope. He already got me over here. Okay, I'll just worry about the crystal lizard later. Because I believe the dragons only spawn once, and you have to use a bonfire aesthetic in order to get them to continue to spawn. Sure have a lot of health. That's why if you have any sort of poison weapons, it works wonderfully here. But basically, you can just go like that for a while, hit them, run back. Just make sure you don't get hit. They don't have a whole lot of health. Deal a decent amount of damage, but... their attack pattern, fairly easy. But that's because I got them locked into this one. And we got a petrified dragon bone. Cool stuff. Now, unfortunately, most of the crystal lizards around here probably ran away. They usually do that when you get anywhere near the dragons here, because generally surrounding the dragons are tons of those crystal lizards. So the best thing to do is just kill the dragon, go to the bonfire, come back, and try to kill all the little guys. But it takes a lot of running back, because there's almost no way you're going to be able to do it within a one running path. And this is another optional way to get to a dragon. If I see in here, let's see if I have any poison stuff. Actually, I do. That makes things rather nice. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and look. There's my lightning shortbow. Barely use the thing. But instead of lightning, I'm going to put poison on it. Now you can poison these guys fairly easily. I think it costs a little bit of Oh, there we go. Okay, now I can just cheese them from up here pretty much, although gotta watch out for this. I don't think he'll be able to get me very much, but you gotta be careful. If you have a ton of these arrows, you can pretty much just cheese any of these dragons here. Just keep them poisoned. There we go. That's a nice little dynamic to what we're doing here. Didn't want to target him. There we go. Now that he's nice and Wow. That went on for way longer than I thought it would. I think that was a bit cheap, to be honest. Totally blocked the first one and got stun locked into it twice. Regardless, dodging the attack is generally fairly easy. I was just fairly reckless about that. But I'm not too terribly worried about the state of things. Now we can explore some of the other areas too. Okie dokie, like up here. There's another dragon. And of course more crystal lizards. Lots and lots of crystal lizards. Tried to hit one. Unfortunately, I totally missed. But yeah, I had a thought actually about how I'm going to tackle the DLC, because I still do want to get to that. But would you guys rather I do it on, let's say, a completely new character, or would you guys rather I do it on this one? Because I had a thought of maybe just completing my playthrough with this guy, and then just starting the DLC on a completely different character. One that, let's say, might be already leveled up. Okay, let's chug really quick. Because this guy is not doing us any favors right now. Okay. But yeah, tell me what you think about the DLC idea. Because if I do end up doing it on this character, I might just go ahead and do the DLC before I finish the game. That way I don't have to go ahead and go on a bunch of New Game Plus stuff before I get back to the DLC, then have to do the DLC on New Game Plus mode when I actually haven't ever done any of the DLC for this before. Anyways, if you notice, we got Dragon's Tooth over there, which is the mace that Havel used in the first game. So that's cool stuff. Got ourselves more petrified dragon bones. Of course, those crystal lizards can drop them. I'm not sure what the drop rate is for that, but there you go. So far, we're not doing too terribly bad. Of course, we still died, but you know, that's Dark Souls, that's expected to happen. Make a lot of stupid mistakes and you're gonna die eventually. Not sure of the purpose of this area up here, to be honest. Maybe it's a way for you to kind of jump attack the dragon, or maybe it's a little bit of a retreat. Or there might have been a crystal lizard up there and I just didn't notice. That's entirely possible too. Anyways, that was one of the little optional areas you could go to. We were kind of heading the right way when we died earlier. Okay. So, I will probably tackle the DLC in the order they were released, starting with the sunken tomb, kingdom, place, whatever, palace. Frankly, I didn't really pay too much attention to it. I didn't play any of them. I was kind of preoccupied doing other stuff at that point in time. Let's see here. There is an item right here, and sounds like there's one of those chain guys really close. I'm not sure where he is, though. Okay, yeah, and this is another little area. Ah, took him out really easily. There we go, and let's see if we can systematically take out more of these guys. See, there's two more. So let's go ahead and take out this one if possible. Whoops. God damn it. Really? Really? Apparently. Wow. Forgot, this weapon kind of sucks for that. Okay, let's see if I can get this one. Nope, I got a... Wow. Wow. Okay, you know, I'm just going to use a different weapon when trying to kill crystal lizards next time, because that is rather dumb. I'm not sure why they would design a weapon like that, to be frank. Well, I mean, with how the hitboxes work with the crystal lizards. Because, I mean, that just swings right over them. Yeah, that makes sense, but shouldn't they at least try to compensate for characters not being able to hit the crystal lizard in general? I mean, that's what it should do, but it's definitely not what happened. Watch that leg. Come on, attack first. Oh, got me on the backswing. A little bit of a revenge here. Awkward camera angles. Up. I'm not sure what he's gonna do. That's what he's gonna do, okay. Come on, heal up, heal up, heal up. Might hit me with his tail. Not sure exactly what he's doing here. Okay. Just a little bit more, and you'll be dead. There we go. Finally, we gained a little vengeance there. And we got Fire Tempest from that one. Pyromancy spell, not really going to be useful to me, but might be useful to somebody else. Okay, Ring of the Evil Eye plus one. Cool stuff, not going to really use it. And Soul of Great Hero, lots and lots of souls around here. It would make sense that a lot of adventurers would try to come up here to kill these dragons. Or perhaps they were taken up here by the dragons and, you know, used as food. Not quite sure which one is the case here. Anyways, that is the bridge I was talking about earlier. When you cross it, you do not want to cross it right now. Especially if you have broken a bunch of eggs. The best thing to do in this case is to just go ahead and... I believe it is go across here, because this will lead you to a new little area you couldn't access beforehand. On top of here. And if you listen, you can hear the bonfire. So we're going to kick this ladder down. Yep, shortcut ahead, pretty obvious. There we go. Sorry, I was mixing up my Dark Souls 1 and 2 ladder stuff, so there we go. So now we can just head straight to the end from climbing up that ladder instead of going through all that other stuff and possibly breaking some eggs. So, okay, let's see our upgrade materials here. How much dragon stuffs do we have? We got 9. That is quite a bit. I think we have... just about enough to upgrade it one or two more times. The Defender's Greatsword, I mean. Can't quite remember how many you need to upgrade it all the way. So I'm gonna go ahead and head back to Majula really quick, and then I am going to upgrade it. If I don't upgrade it all the way, that's fine. There's still plenty of other ways to get the dragon bones.
You've been what?
Gonna talk to her really quick, see if she expanded. Nope.
No injury.
Yep. Okay.
Huh.
Let's go ahead and reinforce weapon and armor. So let's see here. Defender's Greatsword, 4 out of 9. And we just got enough to go to plus 5. Okay, cool stuff.
I'll be around.
So let's see here. This is 203, and Defender's Greatsword is 200. However, its magic damage is not that great. But it does have a okay amount of scaling and lightning damage, less so than this. So frankly, it's a toss-up between these two. This one's just outright better. But this is the one that we're going to be using for the rest of the playthrough. If only because it has some nice effects, like the sunlight blade effect that it has on it. So I'm going to attune spells because I don't need Sunlight Blade anymore. So I'm going to put something else on there, not sure what. Maybe Heavenly Thunder. Let's see here. Probably Great Lightning Spear because we are almost enough to use it. You know what? Just because we're almost enough doesn't mean we're there. Okay. Grit heal just in case. Okay, let's head back. That way I don't have to use a, an Estus flask if, I end up in an area where I can actually heal for a bit and not, get attacked. Sorry about that. That was my phone. Okie dokie, here we go. Let's go ahead and grab back onto this. And because I'm not sure if we killed all the crystal lizards over here, let's go ahead and go back this way. Let's see if we can actually hit some of them this time. Yeah, there's still that one. Oh, that one's running away. Come on, get back here. Oh, almost. Unfortunately, I killed an egg. I hope that doesn't affect my timer with the bridge all that much. If it does, oh well, I can always get back here really easily. It's just more of a hindrance than anything else. There we go. Dragon Shrine time. Probably one of the more annoying places of the game for me, if only because the enemies... Oh, yeah. Oh, it's this guy again. Let me shut up.
Young Hollow, how you grapple with a photo of this dreadfully twisted world. Peace grants men the illusion of life. Shackled by fools who stay young for love, unaware of his grand illusion. Until the curse touches the flesh. We are bound by this yoke. As true as the dark that turns within men. All men trust fully the illusion of life. But is this so wrong? A construction of a facade, and yet a woeful of warmth and scandals. Young Hollow, are you intent on shattering the yoke? Spoiling this wonderful falsehood?
I think so.
I am Aldia. I sought to shed the yoke of fate.
Aldia, huh? As in Aldia's keep?
Now, I only await an answer. Seek the throne. Seek light, dark, and what lies beyond.
Oh, wow. Well, that was interesting. I do like the, lore there, talking about how, or insinuating how life was basically just a facade, insinuating that, humans, their natural state is the dark, which makes sense in the first Dark Souls where all humans started looking as those hollows. So is the undead curse really a curse, or is it just going back to what humans once were? Pretty interesting stuff. Okay, let's go ahead up here. And before we attack that guy, I want to go ahead and get some, let's see here. Do I have any repair powder on me? Yes, we do. Okay, that's good. That's good. In fact, that's fantastic. We're gonna need that. Oh, yep, there's that guy. I still have my bow equipped, right? Okay, good. You know, I actually forgot about this guy. So, first of all, we're gonna try and attack him as much as possible. I kinda dodged... great, now he's gone to me. Great. Okay. Is he going to, nope, it seems he only goes up to there. Okay. Let me see if I can headshot this guy. Almost. Maybe a little bit higher? Or will the, little invisible wall there prevent me? Oh, almost. And... wow, okay. That traveled a long way. Probably get him one last time. Wow, that thing has a really, really large radius. Okay, regardless, I don't think we have a whole lot of time to mess with that guy. Let me pop into here. I don't think that guy can go over there, and... don't think that does anything. Is it a, trap? Nope. Bonfire aesthetic. Times three, that's quite a lot. Try sniper spot. Try jumping. Jumping sounds like a terrible idea, to be honest. Hmm. Praise the sun. That's pretty cool. Okay, this guy certainly wants to have at us, so let's go ahead and give that to him then. Dead. And that's the power of this weapon. Drake Keeple Shield. Cool stuff. Of course, there's this right here. I have plenty of Ferris Lockstones, so I'm just going to use them. I want to say this is mage stuff, but I don't quite remember. Yeah, staff, mage. It's pretty cool stuff, but not for me. Might use it for maybe some fashion stuff, but other than that, not a whole lot useful for my purposes. I'm gonna use this again. Because we're going to want to take out this guy. Wow, okay, yep, he's angry. He is very angry. Wow, okay, yep. You know, I figured I was going to have enough time to heal before he killed me there, but apparently not. Second death of the episode. But really, I'm not too terribly concerned about stuff like that. Okay, I think it's about time to go ahead and go human. I think. Although, from what I saw, invasions are happening here quite a bit, so I could get invaded. Of course, I could get invaded at any time, really, but from what I understand, if you're human, you have a higher chance. Yeah, you do a lot of damage two-handed to that. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. Wow, he is... oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, that guy is wrecking us right now. That guy up there really kind of screwed with me because he hit me a bit earlier. And for some reason, one of those guys' hits looked like it hit me before his animation even started, which is fairly odd. I'm... not really sure what to say about that, to be honest. All I know is that if I keep having trouble, I might have to cut out part of the episode. I don't like doing that, but, you know, them's the breaks, essentially. But I think we can take out the guy up here really quick. Of course, he's right there. Let's go ahead and roll out of the way. He can only come down here so much. But this sunlight blade type spell is what we got the thing for. Well, what we got it for in general, because we would very much like a free sunlight blade, essentially. It's especially nice when you can put it on a weapon that has a fairly high faith modifier. I mean, this one isn't terribly great, but it isn't, like, you know, terrible in general. So we're gonna go back down there. Let me go ahead and actually put on a couple healing items. Radiant Life Gem. I should really buy more of those, but I find myself not doing it very often. And let's go ahead and actually use some of our faith spells. Oh, he just did it as soon as he saw us. Gonna soften him up a bit. And I'm gonna one-hand it just so I can block if needed, which frankly I should have done in the first place. Because he does not take out a lot of stamina damage. Wow, he is just going right at it. So how many combos does he have? Holy crap. God damn, dude, calm down. Attacked like 8 straight times there. Then again, a lot of the enemies in this area seem to have that effect too. Just keep attacking and attacking and attacking. It's a bit odd, to be frank. Do I want to go this way? I think I have to. I can't quite remember, though. I think I have to. Yeah, because that area leads down to here. Yeah, I think I do. Great. Okay, at least I can get to fight these guys one at a time if I do this right. Dang, I was banking on me killing him there before he could continue hurting me, but apparently that wasn't the case. Yeah, you go ahead and just look straight there in the corner. I'll just go right behind you. That was convenient. Sniper spots. Yeah, this is one of the more infamous parts of the game, I think. If only because this area is very, very annoying for a lot of people. Mainly because these guys, there's just so many enemies in a very small spot. So it really is hard to get them in small groups at a time. There we go. So the best I can do is just try to take out as many as I can with bow and arrow. And then confront them when they have a little bit low health like that. See, because those guys, if I go up any farther, they'll go ahead and aggro as well. Which we obviously do not want. Especially because they combo really, really a lot. Thankfully, the hitboxes on the attacks for him is wonky here, so we are doing okay, I think. Okay, well, let's go ahead and grab this guy now. Okay, there we go. Come on. Now these guys, they are almost pretty unrelenting. They'll attack and attack and attack and attack. Thankfully, I can backstab these guys, though. Not sure what he was doing there. I think they have pretty high poise, too. are you doing? Wow. Yeah. Okay. Apparently they deal lots of damage, too. Okay, I think I will go ahead and just cut out to back there so you guys don't have to worry about watching or rewatching all that stuff. So I'll go back there and I will see you guys in a bit. And I'm back. Actually, there is a little bit of an item I missed right over there. Now, in order to get that, you can just run and jump. Go ahead and grab that. It says, try ranged battle. With that guy right there, I believe they're talking about. But yeah, Drake Keeper's Great Axe and Drake Keeper's Great Shield, so that's there if you want it. I am gonna go ahead and cut out again, and I'll see you guys back at the staircase. See you guys in a bit. Okay, and I'm back, and I killed the two giants already. So now we just gotta worry about those guys again. These are pretty much the last obstacle that we need in order to get to where we need to go. However, these guys are, as you can see, pretty unrelenting. They deal a lot of damage. A stupid amount of damage for basically how fast they attack too, which is a bit ridiculous. So frankly, I should probably get some regen on or something, because this is going to not be good otherwise. Thankfully, they like to back off here. Could be a little bit aggressive as they're going up the stairs there. But if you can get more than a couple hits in, then you can finally break their poise. Takes a bit, though. You almost have to not play fair against them. But that's Dark Souls. Not playing fair is kind of how we do it. Okay. Don't believe there's anything other else around here. Let's go ahead and try and lock onto that guy. There we go. Now, this guy has two axes. He can deal just about as much damage as the other guy, so you gotta be very, very careful how you approach attacking him. Especially since they like to use that guard break move. I'm trying to backstab him, if only because it'll be easier. Because hitting him once is not going to break his poise. They do like to roll, as you can see, though. So if I can hit him one more time, there we go. Awesome. Okay, I think there may be one or two enemies, or that might have been it. Or is that one up there? Yeah. Let's see here. Here we go. Yep. These guys. These guys aren't fun. So we're going to poison the heck out of these guys. And back the hell off and deal as much damage as possible. Before we get wrecked. Because we do not want to get wrecked going this far. As we already have. Anyway, he's almost dead. Good, took out that one. Oh, that just totally missed me, the last hit. Okay, I might want to back off a bit. Oh, that could have been bad. Okay, yeah. That actually did some damage to my shield, I think. And we are going to pop that. Ah, damn it. Just straight out of the range. Okay, come on. Let's do this. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do! Oh, god damn it. Friggin' shield. Run, 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 run. Might not even get to use the rest of my, buff at this point. See if I can get a hit in. Yep, one. It's not much. At least I'm doing some damage. And I can eat an amber herb if needed. Seems that shield doesn't, block against magic very well, specifically, lightning. Let's see if he goes backwards. Nope. Okay. Only a couple more hits now. And now he's dead. Okay. I was having a much harder time than I really should have. But I don't go to this area often. It's kind of a late game, so, you know. Oh. You. Fantastic. That's what repair powder is for, though, folks. Same thing. Oh, it seems he didn't like me using repair powder. Okay, let's go ahead and run back really quick. Nope, he's pursuing. I wanted to get on my buff before I fought him, but, I don't think that'll be possible. Yeah, now it will be. Have at ye. Okay, let's see here. Come on. Fantastic. Can now believe that's all of them. My god. Gotta get a steady supply of this repair powder so I can use this buff whenever I really feel like it. Okay, now we don't have to worry about the enemies attacking us too later. This guy looks fairly ominous, but he's actually a pretty neutral NPC, so let's go ahead and talk to him. The Ashen Mist Heart. And he doesn't say anything more. Now, the Ashen Mist Heart is a pretty interesting item. Let me see if I can find it really quick. I'm not sure if it's under a particular one. Should probably just be in our regular inventory. Okay. The Ashen Mist Heart. Do-do. Looking for the Ashen Mist Heart. Kind of hard to find. Probably not here. Anyways, it allows us to go into Dryant's dreams, essentially. So around the area, or various areas, I should say, you should have noticed a couple Giant's corpses, essentially. They look like they're trees. Here it is. Yeah. It basically allows you to go into the dreams, quote-unquote, of those giants, and essentially allows you to relive some history, essentially. which is pretty interesting stuff. So, now that we got these items too right here, these are for the DLC. We're gonna go into the new DLC using this one here very soon, probably within the next couple episodes actually, because the new areas that we are now allowed to go into via the item we just got, they aren't very long areas. Each one can be done within about 5 minutes or so. So I think I'm going to end it off here with a very cool dragon in the background. So thank you guys for joining me on, I believe, the 31st or 32nd episode of our Dark Souls 2 Faith Build playthrough. On the next episode, we're probably going to go into some Giant's Dreams, and then, depending on how people like it, we'll either kill the boss and I'll go into the DLC with a completely new character, or I'll just go ahead, end it there, and we'll go to the DLC before ending it off. So, tell me what you guys want in the comments. Once again, those choices were go ahead and finish the game and do the DLC on a different character. I already have other characters that are leveled up to the right level, so we shouldn't have any problem with that. Or go ahead and stop the game right before we kill the last boss and just head into the DLC with this character under a different playthrough, and then finish it off later. So, tell me what you think in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye, everybody. Take care. And see y'all next time.